lifestyle and balanced by the pound. Surely never act wild, very low key on the profile. Catching feelings is a no. Let me tell you how it goes. Curves the word, spins the verb. Loving it, curse, so freak what you heard. Rolling with the fatness, you never quite know what that happens. You got to pay to play, just for shorty bang bang to look your way. I like the way you work it, tough nuts, trump tight every day. You're blowing my mind, baby, in time. Maybe I can get you in my ride. I like the way you work it, no diggity. Bag it, bag it up now. I like the way you work it, no diggity. I'm about to bag it up. I like the way you work it, no diggity. I'm about to bag it up. Bag it up. I like the way you work it, no diggity.
My channel. Today I'm super excited because Mitch, my boyfriend, for those of you that don't know, has just left to go to a Bucks weekend. So for those women out there who live with a man, it's often nice to have the whole house to yourself, to be able to do things that you wouldn't really usually do with a partner in the house. So my best friend's coming over for a sleepover tonight and we're making this massive healthy feast. So I'm in charge of the healthy feast. So I'm gonna vlog what I make and it's gonna be really nice. Like I'm gonna make sure it's really yummy. So I'll vlog that recipe, whatever it is, I'm not sure yet. I'm also going to a facial because from today I'm actually changing my skincare routine. I'm going to get a facial from a woman who's quite renowned in Brisbane for clearing people's acne and scars and things like that. So she uses a few different products and she also uses LED light, and I had a little phone consult with her talking about sort of my problem areas, my scars and everything, and she's quite certain that she can help me. So this isn't sponsored, by the way. I researched the hell out of different places in Brisbane and I found one which I've heard like amazing things about. She also really helped my friend who had acne. She had like a before and after and it was amazing. So she's all into holistic healing, so I thought it would tie in quite well with Project Glow, because obviously right now I'm being really clean with eating and stuff like that. So in terms of my skin, like with digestion and everything, my face is super clear, but I'm still quite hormonal because my hormones are a bit imbalanced and I'm still a bit stressed. I probably won't take the vlog into the facial because she doesn't know. I haven't asked whether I can film and it just gets awkward. So I will tell you about it afterwards. Hey everyone, so I've just gotten back from my facial. As you can tell, my skin is very white. If you guys didn't know, I fake tan my body, so obviously my face is so white, can't even deal. So firstly, the facial that I just had was absolutely amazing. The person that I went to treats you holistically, so she goes through absolutely everything, but I don't want to touch on that whole experience in this vlog just because I want to cover a few other things in this vlog, aka my gluten-free sweet potato pizza that I'm about to make for the royal wedding that I'm about to watch tonight. So I will let you in on my little healthy feast. I will also in another vlog tell you about the new skincare products I'm using, but I'm only going to tell you about them once I've used them for 2 to 3 weeks, just to ensure that I'm recommending a product that actually works for me and that I'm not just recommending any old products. I want to quickly touch on, I went to Mecca before I went to the facial because I wanted to cover up my skin before I left the... There are people walking past me. I wanted to cover up my skin before I left the facial because I was going shopping and my skin was super inflamed because I just had like this electromagnetic treatment on or whatever it is. So I did just cover up my face, and as you can see, I've got quite like a white complexion. So I ended up getting a super white, like a very light concealer, and it's by Hourglass, and the color I got was vanilla. I really like Hourglass. I already used some of their foundation, but I find that it's super light and it doesn't make me break out. So I've already put it on my face. It's really nice. It blends really evenly, and also it's sort of a bit dewy, which I like. And the second Makeup that I use right now is Bare Minerals Medium Beige Foundation. I was wearing it at the beginning of this video, so you would have seen it was super dewy. It's really great coverage and it also doesn't make me break out. I've been using this for about 3 years and it's honestly my favorite product. Just always make sure you wash your mineral brush because that shit harbors bacteria. So I'm going to stop rambling and get straight into making this pizza. Now, I'm not gonna film the whole recipe, but I'm just gonna film a few steps and then give you the recipe in the description section below this video. A lot of people always ask me where the recipe is. I put it in the description, so if you just check below, you will get the whole recipe for this meal. So stay tuned, and I mean, to be honest, I've never even made this before, so it may taste like shit, so this video may not even exist, but we will see. Okay, so before I go into the whole recipe, I just want to say that today I purchased cashew cheese for the first time, and holy crap, it tastes like feta. It's so amazing, and this whole dish is going to be dairy free because my friend is lactose intolerant and I can't eat dairy anyway. So I'm hoping, I've never actually made a gluten-free pizza without cheese before, because back in the day I just had it anyway, even though I couldn't eat it. So we will see how it goes, but I have high hopes. So here I've got some chopped up pumpkin. I'm gonna put that in the oven to bake and have as a topping for the pizza. Excuse the wire. I've got some chopped up broccoli because I love putting spices on the broccoli and then putting it on the pizza. I've got some sun-dried tomatoes, some basil. I've got some brown rice flour to go in the base. And then over here, I've actually just, hold up. I've blended cauliflower, garlic, olive oil, egg, and salt and paprika in the blender. And then here I'm just boiling some sweet potato. That's just about done. I'm going to put it in the blender, blend it up so it's all smooth, and then I'm going to put it into a separate bowl and knead it with some flour. So I'm going to get it into a thick dough-like texture using the brown rice flour. You can use other types of flour. Obviously some people, if they're paleo, they probably wouldn't have brown rice flour. I'm fine with brown rice flour, but other alternatives are buckwheat, almond meal, and even tapioca flour if you want to use it. I've got some organic chicken marinating, and I'm going to have that as just a side with the pizza because Becky, my friend, is a really big eater, so I feel like I had to have some protein. And then I'm going to roast some onion as well. Okay guys, we're halfway through the base. I'm gonna try a little crispy bit back. It's not cooked, fully cooked, but it's not like. So I'm just gonna wait for it to get crispy.
It does not taste like shit.
Let's see if we can do it. And then Becky's bought the old kombucha for later and some chops.